Daily evening prayer. Monday, June 24th, 2024. Jesus spoke to them, saying, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done, and apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess their faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed. Now as we come to the setting of the sun, and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. Blessed are those who are undefiled in their ways and walk in the law of the Lord. Blessed are those who keep his testimonies and seek him with their whole heart. Even those who do no wickedness and perfectly walk in his ways. You have ordered your precepts that we should diligently keep them. Oh, that my ways were made so direct that I may keep your statutes. Then would I not be put to shame while I give heed unto your commandments. I will thank you with an upright heart when I have learned your righteous judgments. I will keep your statutes. I will keep your statutes. Oh, do not forsake me utterly. How shall a young man cleanse his way? By ruling himself according to your word. With my whole heart I have sought you. Oh, let me not go astray from your commandments. Your words have I hidden within my heart, that I may not sin against you. Blessed are you, O Lord, teach me your statutes. With my lips have I been telling of all the judgments of your mouth. I have had greater delight in the way of your testimonies than in all manner of riches. I will meditate on your commandments and have respect for all your ways. My delight will be in your statutes, and I will not forget your word. O do well unto your servant, that I may live and keep your word. Open my eyes that I may see the wondrous things of your law. I am a sojourner on earth, O hide not your commands from me. My soul is consumed with the fervent desire that it always has for your judgments. You have rebuked the proud, and cursed are those who stray from your commandments. O turn from me shame and contempt, for I have kept your testimonies. Though princes sit and speak against me, yet will your servant meditate on your statutes. For your testimonies are my delight, and they are my counselors. My soul cleaves to the dust. O revive me according to your word. I have acknowledged my ways, and you heard me. O teach me your statutes. Make me to understand the way of your commandments, and so shall I meditate on your wondrous works. My soul melts away for heaviness. Comfort me according to your word. take me from the way of lying, and graciously teach me your law. I have chosen the way of truth, and your judgments have I set before me. I hold fast to your testimonies, O Lord. Let me not be put to shame. I will run the way of your commandments. When you enlarge my heart with understanding, glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the prophet Daniel, beginning with the third chapter, the first verse. Nebuchadnezzar, the king, made a statue of gold, a height of which was 60 cubits, and its width 6 cubits. He set it up on the plain of Dura in the province of Babylon. Nebuchadnezzar, the king, also sent word to assemble the satraps, the prefects, and the governors, the counselors, the chief treasurers, the judges, the magistrates, and all the administrators of the provinces to come to the dedication of the statue that Nebuchadnezzar, the king, had set up. Then the satraps, the prefects, and the governors, the counselors, the chief treasurers, the judges, the magistrates, and all the administrators of the province, other provinces were assembled for the dedication of the statue of Nebuchadnezzar, the king, had set up. And they stood before the statue. And they stood before the statue that Nebuchadnezzar had set up. Then the herald loudly proclaimed, "To you the command is given, you peoples, nations, and populations of all languages, that at the moment you hear the sound of the horn, flute, lyre, trigon, psaltery, bagpipe, and all kinds of musical instruments, you are to fall down and worship the golden statue that Nebuchadnezzar the king has set up. But whoever does not fall down and worship shall immediately be thrown into the middle of a furnace of blazing fire. Therefore, as soon as all the people heard the sound of the horn, flute, lyre, trigon, psaltery, bagpipe, and all kinds of musical instruments, all the peoples, nations, and populations of all languages fell down and worshipped the golden statue that Nebuchadnezzar, the king, had set up. For this reason, at that time, certain Chaldeans came forward and brought charges against the Jews. They began to speak and said to Nebuchadnezzar, the king, O king, live forever. You, O king, made a decree that every person who hears the sound of the horn, lute, lyre, trigon, psaltery, and bagpipe, and all kinds of musical instruments, is to fall down and worship the golden statue. But whoever does not fall down and worship shall be thrown into the middle of a furnace of blazing fire. There are certain Jews whom you have appointed over the administration of the province of Babylon, namely Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. These men, O king, have disregarded you. They do not serve your gods, nor do they worship the golden statue which you have set up. Then Nebuchadnezzar, in rage and anger, gave orders to bring Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Then these men were brought before the king. Nebuchadnezzar began speaking and said to them, Is it true, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, that you do not serve my gods, nor worship the golden statue that I have set up? Now if you are ready, at the moment you hear the sound of the horn, lute, lyre, trigon, psaltery, and bagpipe, and all kinds of musical instruments, to fall down and worship the statue that I have made, very well. But if you do not worship, you will immediately be thrown into the midst of a furnace of blazing fire. And what God is there who can rescue you from my hands? Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego replied to the king, Nebuchadnezzar, we are not in need of an answer to give you concerning this matter. If it be so, our God whom we serve is able to rescue us from the furnace of blazing fire. And he will rescue us from your hand, O king. But even if he does not, let it be known to you, O king, that we are not going to serve your gods, nor worship the golden statue that you have set up. Then Nebuchadnezzar was filled with wrath, and his facial expression was changed towards Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. He answered by giving orders to heat the furnace 7 times more than it was usually heated. And he ordered certain valiant warriors who were in his army to tie up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in order to throw them into the furnace of blazing fire. And these men were tied up in their trousers, their coats, their caps, and their other clothing, and were thrown into the middle of the burning of the furnace of blazing fire. For this reason, because the king's command was harsh and the furnace had been made extremely hot, the flame of the fire killed those men who took up Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. But these 3 men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, fell into the middle of the furnace of blazing fire, still tied up. Then Nebuchadnezzar the king was astounded and stood up quickly. He said to his counselors, "Was it not 3 men that we threw bound into the middle of the fire?" They replied to the king, "Absolutely, O king." He responded, "Look, I see 4 men untied and walking about in the middle of the fire, unharmed. And the appearance of the fourth is like the son of the gods. It's like a son of the gods." Then Nebuchadnezzar came near to the door of the furnace of blazing fire. He said, "Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, come out, you servants of the Most High God, and come here." Then Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came out of the middle of the fire. The satraps, the prefects, the governors, and the king's counselors gathered together and saw that the fire had no effect on the bodies of these men, nor was the hair of their heads singed, nor were their trousers damaged, nor had even the smell of fire touched them. Nebuchadnezzar responded and said, Blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who has sent his angel and rescued his servants who put their trust in him, violating the king's command, and surrendered their bodies rather than serve or worship any god except their own god. Therefore I make a decree that any people, nation, or population of any language that speaks anything offensive against the god of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego shall be torn limb from limb, and their houses made a rubbish heap, because there is no other god who is able to save in this way." And the king made Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego prosperous in the province of Babylon. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden. For behold, from now on all generations will call me blessed. For he that is mighty has magnified me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is on those who fear him throughout all generations. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their thrones, and has exalted the humble and meek. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away. He, remembering his mercy, has helped his servant Israel, as he promised to our fathers, Abraham, and his seed forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles, beginning with the 20th chapter, the first verse. After the uproar had ceased, Paul sent for the disciples, and when he had encouraged them and taken his leave of them, he left to go to Macedonia. When he had gone through those regions and had given them much encouragement, he came to Greece, and there he spent 3 months. And when a plot was formed against him by the Jews, as he was about to set sail for Syria, he decided to return through Macedonia. And he was accompanied by Sopater of Berea, the son of Pyrrhus, and by Aristarchus and Secundus of the Thessalonians, and Gaius of Derbe, and Timothy, and Tychicus, and Trophimus, and Trophimus of Asia. Now these had gone on ahead and were waiting for us at Troas. We sailed from Philippi after the days of unleavened bread, and reached them at Troas within 5 days, and we stayed there for 7 days. On the first day of the week, when we were gathered together to break bread, Paul began talking to them, intending to leave the next day, and he prolonged his message until midnight. There were many lamps in the upstairs room where we were gathered together, and there was a young man named Eutychus sitting on the window sill, sinking into a deep sleep. And as Paul kept on talking, Eutychus was overcome by sleep and fell down from the third floor, and he was picked up dead. But Paul went down and fell upon him, and after embracing him, he said, "Do not be troubled, for he is still alive." When Paul had gone back up and had broken the bread and eaten, he talked with them a long while until daybreak, and then left. They took away the boy alive and were greatly comforted. But we went ahead to the ship to set sail for Assos, intending from there to take Paul on board, for that was what he had arranged, intending himself to go by land. And when he met us at Assos, we took him on board and came to Mytilene. Sailing from there, we arrived the following day opposite Chios, and the next day we crossed over to Samos, and on the following day we came to Miletus, for Paul had decided to sail past Ephesus so that he would not have to lose time in Asia, for he was hurrying if it might be possible for him to be in Jerusalem the day of Pentecost. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Lord, now let your servant depart in peace according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles, and to be the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us, and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us, and lead us in the way of justice. And lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness, and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people, and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the world be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Almighty God, by whose providence your servant John the Baptist was wonderfully born and sent to prepare the way of your Son, our Savior, by preaching repentance, make us so to follow his teaching and Holy life, that we may truly repent, boldly rebuke vice, patiently suffer for the sake of truth, and proclaim the coming of Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Lord of all power and might, the author and giver of all good things, graft in our hearts the love of your name, increase in us true religion, nourish us with all goodness, and bring forth in us the fruit of good works. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, the source of all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works, give to your servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey your commandments, and that we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. O God, you manifest in your servants the signs of your presence. Send forth upon us the spirit of love, that in companionship with one another, your abounding grace may increase among us, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.